You also had no trouble with transporting human heads in designer bags on a plane. Could you tell me about that?
I had a lot of trouble trying to transport those heads. This was in a very different time. You know, life has changed in terms of our transportation and what we're allowed to do these days. But a gentleman in Verona was arrested by police, and he was accused of... initially, he was accused of sexual predator and requesting that prostitutes undertake activities with him that were illegal. When they looked through some several thousand photographs that he had in his premises, they found one of a young lady, and they believed that the damage to her could only have happened when she was dead. So that set off an investigation around the farm to say, are we going to find bodies? And they did find several bodies of young ladies who, many of them had bags over their head, and he'd obviously suffocated them and, we suspect, tied rope around their neck as well. We knew that most of these were probably prostitutes, and prostitutes can have a very chaotic lifestyle and be very transient. So they may come into that job for a while and then move on. Mm. And so when they're no longer working in a particular area, people assume often that they've just moved on to something else. And when they go missing, nobody alerts the police to it. So we suspect that what we had were prostitutes. We knew that there were a couple of named ladies who were missing. And the question that the Italian police posed to us was, could either of these two women be in the bodies that we found? And I think they found about seven or eight bodies on his land. And there were two in particular that they believed could be them. Now, you've got to bear in mind, this is in the days when DNA was still in its infancy. So nowadays, what we do is we take a DNA sample from the remains. We'd go and check them with mum and dad or brothers and sisters, but we didn't have that. And one of the things that the police wanted to do was to try to superimpose photographs of the skull onto the photographs that we had of the missing women. Yeah. And that required us to have a particular photographic setup, which we had in Glasgow, but they didn't have in Verona. So it meant that the two women's heads had to be transported from Verona to Glasgow. And what they decided they would do, the authorities, was that I would carry both heads as hand luggage. And to conceal it, the heads were placed each in sealed white plastic buckets, and then each bucket placed in a very expensive designer Italian firm carrier bag, which I won't name who it was. I had one letter in Italian, one letter in English to explain what I was carrying, that I had the authority to carry it, and why we were doing it. But you can imagine the scenario when you rock up to the front of the airport, and you go through security, and they say, put your bags on, you know, the scanner. So you have to hand over the letter that says, here's what's in here. And they were so horrified by it. You know, they just said, please go through. And that was my experience all the way from Verona to Glasgow, was that nobody wanted to look, fortunately, I think, inside those bags and inside those buckets to see whether what I was carrying was what I really said it was. And it just turned into such a farce in many ways, but not something that would happen today. It was off its time.
Did it even, were there even X-ray machines to go through?
They did. So they were going to put it through the X-rays machines. And I said, look, please, please read the letter first. Because if you look up on the screen and what you see is a skull facing you, you know, that's a trauma for the person on the end of the screen. So I was very clear and very careful to every stage of the authority that they knew beforehand. And it was almost as if I was contagious. They just moved me on swiftly.
As I would do if I were working there. I would not want to look at that. If you wanted to smuggle anything, that would have been the time to do it.
Wouldn't it? But, you know, we wouldn't do that these days.
What a story. What was the reaction on the plane like?
So there were two planes. There was the first plane that took me from Verona to London. And the air hostess said, you know, sorry, madam, but you need to put your bags in the hold. And I said, no, I can't put my bags in the hold because this is continuity of evidence. Here's the letter. And she read the letter and was clearly horrified. And she moved me down to business class, which I thought was actually rather nice. But she moved me down to business class and isolated me as if I had barbed wire around me and ignored me for the entirety of the flight. And when I got onto the plane to go then from London to Glasgow, I did exactly the same thing. But this time I was isolated to the back of the plane and everybody else got moved up to business class. So it's obviously a policy. Isolate the forensic anthropologist who's carrying heads in a bucket.